wonders in the Christendom.
All Jesus is saying. and you know that happened correctly. If you had that reason after the death of your God, what did you believe? He apologized. But see what he told him. And he said unto them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Only two people among you here that are telling the world about what you are seeing in this ministry. You know what God doesn't like about what we are doing? You know, every Thursday I preach. And almost every day they are always informing you to welcome new members from all over. The gospel of Christ. And it's making people all over the world to come out of this old covenant of sacrifice. So, I'm telling you now. If you are not evangelizing, you are not doing well. Somebody about Christ. Look, I don't know where we can keep to the teaching of Christ as we are doing here. That's why, because when I preach in the air, you know, the church, this ministry's church worldwide, is almost 10 times those of you are here. When I broke down before the Lord raised me up, I received a lot of response, sympathy, all the way to they were telling me, may the Lord strengthen you, because we are just opening our eyes to what God wants. And you are really praying for me. I'm challenging you today. If you have not been talking about what God is doing, you are failing God. Today, like a watchman like myself, that God has raised in your corner, in your family, to tell them about the acceptable message of Christ. The good thing is, if you do it, it means you are wise. Look at the book of Proverbs chapter 11 verse 30. You will see that even before Christ came, it's been written that whoever wins soul is wise. In Proverbs 11 verse 30, the fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that wins soul is wise. Are you going there? Somebody help you to know here. Why are you holding this information to yourself? Evangelism goes on here. As I'm doing it at international level, it goes on here every Thursday evening. to come out of this dead old covenant and come into the living covenant of Christ. And you'll be surprised. Many will follow you. Convert them. But we are telling them, at least they know that there is a ministry that is teaching only the gospel. Leave the rest in the hand of God. So make it a habit that every time you invite people to Christ. And there is gain there for you. Listen to this. In Daniel chapter 12. Daniel chapter 12. Verse 3. And he that be wise shall shine as the brightness of the family. And he that turn many to righteousness as it stands forever and ever.
The maxim, Iwe Daniel, orikeji life of better. Awon lokun yo si ma tun bi mole ofun. Awon to si nji opolopo pada si ododo yo ma tun bi irawo life ati life.
So by not doing it, you are denying yourself the launch.
Nipa pe e ni se e padamo opolopo ni.
I challenge you to be.
Ogo yin le ja loni.
Challenge you to be. If you want these people, many who are still in the hands of false prophets, to be free, tell them about Christ. Our beloved brother here was saying, is something wrong with us? Why are we not, obeying like people of old? No, it's not for us. For instance, now you have changed. I want you. I'm asking. I want you to change. I have changed. Many of us who are here, we have changed from stubbornness. No, what you are hearing, you are doing it now. Continue. What does that tell other people? I trust God. As you tell other people, they will come. They will be part of the church. They too, when they come, they will tell other people. And little by little, the world will turn away from this deadly old covenant. I must commend those of you who are into it. You come here with us. Continue. You will not miss your reward. I'm not missing my reward. God is there for me. And you can do the same for me. And great things are happening here. See, when Jesus told them to go and preach, they went. What follows? Signs and wonders. Look at it in verse 20 of Mark chapter 16. Now, and they went forth and preached everywhere, the Lord walking with them and confirming the word, the signs following. I pray for you and for myself that as we go telling other people, signs and wonders will church here will grow. God will use you. I said, God will use you. So let's repent of our not evangelizing. Let's go and let the world know. Believe it. As we do, you will see more people will come to knowledge of these truths. The second video has to do with our offering. You know, offering normally is what we use to help ourselves in the church. But again, we are failing in that area. We're not giving. It should not be so. You see, the more you give to God, the more blessings you receive. If you are not in giving to God, you are not. Remember, if I'm not interested in your money. Look, I give money adequately. So that the brethren we are taking care of, with the ones who are also bring, we can keep taking care of them. Old women, old men, and it is the money that we are bringing that we use to cater for ourselves. So, give unto God. In Luke chapter 6, verse 38, if you have not been giving, please join also. In Luke 6:38. Give, and shall be given unto you good measure, pressed down, and shaken together, and running over. Shall men give into your bosom, for with the same measure that ye make Lord, it shall be measured to you again.
Two messages that
God has sent me to you. God understands that you needed this. That's why God has given you. I know by the time I come again, it is commendation that God will send me to send to the church. We are glad that as we go out to preach, at least we are seeing signs. Somebody who has been looking for a job for so many months, years, today you can see what he's seeing. And there are others too, the Lord is opening the door unto. So, as we give, as we preach, we shall never miss our rewards in Jesus' name. Before I finally go and sit down,
so Lord Jehovah,
I will ask you this question. And I'd like you to answer. Like Moses, God told him, give the law to the children of Israel. If they do it, they will live. But if they don't do it, they will die. He also said, we shall do all God told them to do. I'm asking you now, let me start from this side. Will you do what God asked me to tell me to do? Offering good offering to God. Second one. I never realized it. Will you do it? Fine. Let me come to here. You have had me to. Will you do what God is asking you to do? That's what you say. And the Lord will back it up in the mighty name of Jesus.
Yes,
thank you very much and God bless you.